This image features my all-time favorite video game character ever. That's right, it's the reticle. The reticle is this little dot or crosshairs or aiming circle that's so common you probably haven't thought much about it. You might think that it's just there to help you aim, and of course, that is a big part of it. But the reticle has other incredibly important, mostly hidden purposes that are easy to take for granted. Not on my watch. No longer will we dismiss the hardest working cluster of pixels on our screens. Our pixelated friend showed up early in arcades, mostly in submarine games like Seawolf, and later on in light gun games like Sega's Jurassic Park. These were basically just real crosshairs moving around the screen as you moved the controller, like a cursor. This is, in the purest sense, a reticle, although it doesn't serve the same purpose as modern reticles, which means it's basically garbage. Battlezone featured a legit stationary aiming reticle, which feels like overkill because you could only pan left or right, so like, how are you gonna miss even? But I mention it because the reticle was dynamic. It changed when you hovered over an enemy. Using reticles to communicate gameplay information is something that's pretty standard now, but it was something first-person shooters just forgot about for like a long time. That's when they had a reticle at all, which a lot of the earliest FPSs did not bother with. Of the early games they did appear in, they were often transparent. So like, not entirely useless, but not really a feature. Kind of like hair dye on a horse. Outside of Halo, which perfected the crosshair in 2001, FPSs generally didn't get wise to using the reticle as a form of communication until the mid-2000s, which is wild because it's right there in the middle of the screen where your eyes are already looking. That makes it a great vehicle for communicating when you're, say, hovering over an enemy, where you can or can't shoot a portal, what ledges you can grapple onto, or what gun you're currently equipping. But that's not even the best service the reticle provides. Because if you're like me and have tried to circle back on those first-person shooters, you've probably experienced the gamer's sour curse. Motion sickness. Or, more specifically, simulation sickness. Scientific research still doesn't totally know what causes simulation sickness. The best idea we have is something called sensory conflict theory, where the input that you're getting visually and aurally differs from the information in your vestibular system. That's the part of your body that controls motor function and balance and lots of other stuff, and also is that weird spiral ear part you might have recognized from Uzumaki. So some of your senses think you're moving, and other senses think you're not, which is confusing. But we don't really know why the body responds by donking up your guts. The best bet is that your lizard brain reacts to the conflict by going, "Ah, I must be hallucinating. It's either from playing this video game or from eating those weird berries I found growing on the subway. But regardless, I should hurl up all these toxins or I might die." Sensory conflict theory doesn't account for why some people suffer from it and others don't, or why some people can train themselves out of feeling it and others never will. What it does explain is why the reticle is so important to preventing simulation sickness. That freckle is a constant, unmoving point on the screen, something to focus on while your avatar is in motion. It helps remind your brain, hey, actually, I'm not doing cool stunts over rooftop air conditioners. I'm almost entirely sedentary, eating Subway berries on my couch, alone. It's the same practice that backs up spotting, a technique where a dancer will keep their eyes trained on one spot as their body executes full spins. In fact, the creators of Mirror's Edge actually consulted with ballerinas to figure out how they can do like 8 spins in a row without decorating the front row with their lunch. Of course, the reticle isn't always enough to stop you from feeling motion sick. There are a lot of other factors like the shakiness of the camera, whether there are any other stable UI elements, how big your screen is, and how close you are to it. And some modern games still somehow don't include reticles even when they really need to. But it's only a few pixels of screen real estate, so it doesn't seem fair to demand it solve all our problems. Instead, the next time you crack open your favorite first-person game, say a quick thank you to your old friend, the reticle.